today we have an interesting lesson. As new believers, we'll be discussing spiritual gifts. We want to learn more about them. What are spiritual gifts? By the end of our lesson this afternoon, we'll be able to tell what are spiritual gifts, where do they come from, how can I identify my gifts, what is the purpose of spiritual gifts, how are they important to the life of the church. So we'll be discussing spiritual gifts. My dear friends, as new believers, people who are growing in Christ, we need to know spiritual gifts. They'll help us to grow. First and foremost, as we begin, let me ask a question to all of us. What comes in your mind when you hear spiritual gifts? Or what is a spiritual gift? In your own understanding, what is a spiritual gift? Yes, sir.
According to my understanding, a spiritual gift is a gift given by the Spirit. And probably the Spirit, this is the Holy Spirit from God.
Okay.
That's how I understand it.
Someone else, when you hear spiritual gift, what would you think it is?
What I think is a spiritual gift is a gift that is given
from God. Okay. So, as it says, spiritual gift, of course, all of us relate it with some work that God gives us. Something like that. Well, we'll be able to hear more as we go on. Let's read now in Ephesians chapter 4. Ephesians chapter 4. We will start with verses 12. To hear more about spiritual gifts. We want to understand, first of all, where do they come from? Where are these spiritual gifts coming from? Where do they come from? So who can read for us Ephesians chapter 4, verses 10. Verses 10 and 11.
Ephesians chapter 4, verses 10 and 11 says, he who descended is the one who also ascended far above all the heavens, that he might fill all things. Verse 11, he gave some to be apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some shepherds and teachers.
So the Bible is discussing that when he ascended on high, who ascended on high?
Jesus
Christ. So when Jesus Christ was here and he preached for 3.5 years, he died for our sins. He was resurrected. When he ascended to heaven, he says he left us gifts. And those are what we call spiritual gifts. So what are spiritual gifts? Spiritual gifts are gifts that Christ or God has given us, has empowered us with. That's what spiritual gifts are. And according to this verse, who is giving the spiritual gifts?
Jesus Christ.
It is God who is giving the spiritual gifts. These spiritual gifts are given by God. When Christ ascended on high, he gave spiritual gifts. Since Jesus is God, then we can simply say this is coming from God. Okay, fine. These spiritual gifts are given by God. They are enablings by his Spirit. But to whom were they given? In the same verse, read again for us verses 10 and read verses 12. Ephesians 4 verse 12. Ephesians 4 verse 12. Ephesians. Where are these spiritual gifts going?
Ephesians 4 verse 12 says, for the perfecting of the saints, to be the work of saving, to be the building up of the body of Christ.
Okay. You can also read 1 Corinthians 12, verse 12.
For the perfecting of the saints, for the works.
1 Corinthians 12, verse 12.
For verse 12.
So then death makes.
1 Corinthians 12, verse 12. So, we have read something interesting from those two passages. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 12 and 1 Corinthians 12 verse 12. Now we want to answer the question, when God gives these spiritual gifts, where is he giving them to? Where are they going? According to this, the verses that we have read. Yes, sir.
They're going to different communities.
Okay. Yes, you wanted to say something?
The saints, just probably the fish and the saints.
Okay. So they are going to individual people who are called the what?
The saints.
So God is giving spiritual gifts to the people. Not any other people, but the people where? In the church. Those that have trusted Christ, like you and I, we have come to trust Christ for salvation. We have put our lives in him. Those that have trusted Christ, he gives us gifts. And these are spiritual gifts. So spiritual gifts are given to believers. Okay. Now think about it for a moment. Are these spiritual gifts given to anyone in the world? To everyone? Does everyone have a spiritual gift in the world? Not really, right? Yes. Because you discover that these spiritual gifts are given directly only to those that have trusted who? Christ. Okay.
The question.
Huh?
Can I ask a question?
Yes, you can ask.
Okay. My question is, I mean, there are these people who've got, say, beautiful voices. Those are gifts, I think, that is from God.
Yes.
Can we say they are spiritual or non-spiritual gifts?
Okay, so we'll get back now to what spiritual gifts are. That's a very nice question, don't you think so?
Yes.
It's a very good question. All right, so we have identified where they are coming from. We have identified where these spiritual gifts are going to the saints. So it's not everyone that has a spiritual gift. It's those that have come in, that have a relationship with God. They are part of the spiritual body, so they have got a spiritual gift. Okay, why did God give spiritual gifts? Why did he give spiritual gifts? Let's get back to Ephesians chapter 4. Read now again on verses 12. We want to identify two reasons why God gave spiritual gifts. What are their purpose? Why are they important? That's what we want to identify now.
Chapter 12, chapter 4, the scripture says, for the perfecting of the saints, to the work of saving, and the building up of the body of Christ.
So why are spiritual gifts given? The Bible says to prepare God's people for works of service. You and I are new believers. You have come in, you have just known Christ, but you want to save him. This message that has warmed your heart about the gospel, you want to share it. You want to enjoy God. But how do you serve him? God needs to give you a spiritual gift. Imagine if all of us didn't have spiritual gifts. How was God going to work in the church? It was going to be difficult. But God now is working in the church because people have spiritual gifts. So spiritual gifts are there so that we can work in the church, so that we can work in the church to prepare God's people for service. Me, as I'm teaching is a spiritual gift. I'm doing service, right? I'm doing a service in God's kingdom. So how can you also do something until you identify, you come to know your spiritual gift? That is number one. Number two, spiritual gifts are there so that the body of Christ may be built up. How do we build the body of Christ? Through spiritual gifts. For example, how do we grow the membership of our church? How do we bring many to repentance and to know Christ? It is through spiritual gifts, through a gift of singing, through the gift of preaching, through the gift of teaching. People are coming where? Into the church. So it is used to bring people in the church, but also it's building the body of God inside as a body. So the church is growing spiritually. We are maturing from glory to glory through different people's spiritual gifts. Like when someone is preaching, they are edifying the church. We are growing. Someone is singing, we are growing. Someone with a gift of hospitality, when they receive us well at church. You see, the church grows because of spiritual gifts. Yes. So that is why the spiritual gifts are important. Those are the two reasons, the purpose of spiritual gifts. Number one, we are saying, for the what? For the work. So that you and I can work. Number two, for growth. So that we can grow as a church and also bring the world on board. Okay. Well, we have talked about what spiritual gifts are, where they come from, the purpose. Now another question. How many spiritual gifts are there? Who can give us examples of spiritual gifts before we come to the Bible? Yes, sir.
There's preaching.
There's preaching, okay. A spiritual gift. Nice.
Teaching.
Spiritual gift. Okay.
Prophecy.
Pardon?
Prophecy.
Prophecy. The gift of prophecy. That's another good spiritual gift. Yes, sir.
Singing.
Another spiritual gift. Hospitality. Giving. All those are what? Spiritual gifts. All right. Let's read some more spiritual gifts in 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Verses 7 to 11. Who can read for us? 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 7 to 11. Who can read for us? Yes, sir.
But the manifestation of the spirits is given to every man to profit with. For to one,
you can read loudly.
But the manifestation of the spirits is given to every man to perfect with. For to one is given by the Spirit the words of wisdom, to another and the word of knowledge by the same Spirit. Together faith by the same Spirit, to another the gift of healing by the same Spirit. To another the work of miracles, to another prophecy. To another discernment of the Spirit. To another diverse of kings of tongues.
The gift of tongues.
The gifts of tongues. To another the interpretation of tongues.
Of tongues.
But to all these works, that one has the self spirit dividing to every man several as he will.
Okay, so there we have a few lists of spiritual gifts, namely the gift of wisdom, another one the gift of healing, the gift of miraculous powers, the gift of prophecy, the gift of discernment. All these are different gifts. Okay, let's go to Ephesians chapter 4. There is another list of gifts there. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11. You can read for us.
Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11. He gave some to be apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some shepherds and teachers.
Okay,
There again, we find a gift of apostleship. Prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers, and of course administrators and what have you. So these are examples of spiritual gifts. Now, just to go through some of these spiritual gifts. Like for example, spiritual gift of teaching. Like I'm doing, this is a spiritual gift of teaching. Singing, when someone is singing, they love singing, that is a spiritual gift. A gift of administration. Some people are gifted with just administration. They know how to mobilize people. They have got those special skills of leadership. They are competent enough to win our influence. That is their gift of administration. Others, a gift of discernment. You know, some of our friends can discern when we are in challenges, when the church is facing rough times, they can discern about the future and advise us. Others have a gift of prophecy. They can read in scripture and see prophetic messages and explain to the rest of all of us. We might not have that spiritual gift of prophecy, but there are others who have them. Like for example, when you go to Revelation, some of us will just read about water and the beasts. We don't know what they mean. But God has blessed some individuals and they know what that means. It does not mean that they just wake up and tell you water means this or what this means what. What they do is the Bible is self-explanatory. John saw things like, not that he saw them as they are. So they can go in scripture, do deep study, and they can see, they can interpret prophecy. Others, in interpretation of tongues. Someone speaks another tongue, then they give an interpretation that what he's saying is this. Others have got a spirit of tongues, knowing many languages. You and I, maybe we just know our local language and English, but there are people who know seven languages. That is a spiritual gift God has given them. So those are some of the spiritual gifts that are there. Now, I have a question for us. On the spiritual gift, there is the gift of apostleship. What do you think? Do we still have that gift today, the gift of apostleship? What would you say?
Yes, sir. I think we still have that gift of apostleship. We still have the gift of apostleship.
Okay. One of the gifts we have here, a gift of apostleship. Who is an apostle? 1 John chapter 1 describes who an apostle is. That an apostle is one who lived with Christ. One who saw Christ. One who labored with Christ for 3 years. That is who an apostle is. When Christ started his mission on earth, the first thing he did was to appoint what? Apostles. How many were they? They were 12. Of course, there were 11, and one threw himself on the group. They became 12. That Judas carried. So that gift of apostleship, Christ appointed himself. So that is why today we don't have the gift of apostleship. Because none of us here so have seen Christ physically and have sat at his feet for 3 years. We have not done that. Okay, Paul claims to be an apostle. Is he an apostle? Why are we saying yes? Exactly. When we read in Galatians, he says, I was in the Libyan desert for how long? 3 years with Christ. He appointed me. So him is an apostle. So us, we can't have that spiritual gift. So those are some of the examples of this spiritual gift. Finally, how do I identify my spiritual gift? How do I know that this is what God has called me to do? How do I know that I can work for God in this way? How do I even find my spiritual gift? Yes, my brother.
I think it can be through church members.
Okay.
They will see the way you are performing, maybe the way you are responding to the service that you offer in the church.
Mm-hmm.
You can be singing, the way you are singing, maybe if it's preaching, the way you preach,
mm-hmm.
you get the comments from people. Oh. So that you can identify your gifts.
So he's saying we can know spiritual gifts from people. People can tell you, you are good at hospitality. You are good. You can sing very well. So through our friends, we can identify as they speak out what they think about us. That's very good. Yes, okay. The man behind the camera.
Yes, for me, I feel it's about trying out. Mm. You really need to try out because these talents, they need to be nurtured. Mm. If you are just there sitting idle, you don't try out to sing, you would not discover if you are good at singing. If you don't try out maybe preaching a sermon at a youth group, you would not know if you are good at preaching, you are a good public speaker.
That's our cameraman. He says you just need to try out and then you identify the gift that God has pressed on your heart. What would others say? How can I identify my spiritual gift? Yes, sir.
I think also by prayer, mm-hmm. by praying every day to God, it will help us know what we are supposed to be doing for Him. And you find that there will be something in which you will be spending most of the time in, if it comes to the work of God, you discover that maybe that's a spiritual gift God has given you, because you are spending more time as compared to some other spiritual gifts. So you'll be able to identify it.
So our brother here says through prayer, you can also pray, God reveal to me my spiritual gift. And he says God can reveal to you your spiritual gift. So in other words, it is ourselves to identify, to do a self audit about our lives. What do we love to do when you come to church now that you are a new believer? What is it that you love doing for Christ, that thing that brings satisfaction in your heart? For some it is singing. When they sing, they are satisfied. But for some of us, we don't have a spiritual gift of singing. We just sing one stanza and our throats are dry. Sing one stanza and we are tired. But others who still continue, they are excited. Others, it's hospitality. Some of us, we want to keep to ourselves, but others are all over the place trying to interact. So you do an introspective of yourself. What gift do I have? As someone said, you can ask around. Your friends can tell you, you are good at this. Good at teaching. You are good at almsgiving. You're always there giving. That's a spiritual gift you have. You have discernment, you know? When you talk to me, you talk as if you're already in the future. You know things. Yeah, so that's your gift. So you ask around. And of course, you try out things. Get involved in the life of the church. Join a singing group. Join an evangelistic program so that you can identify your spiritual gift. And above all, we are saying you pray. Ask God for your spiritual gift. All right. Now that we have learned about spiritual gifts, what they are, where they come from, I want all of us to share their spiritual gifts. We'll start with our friend here coming this way. Each one of us, let's share.
My spiritual gift, according to people, as you have said, friends can tell our spiritual gifts. And probably they come from the same spirit. So we're given different gifts. Others can have more than one gift. So people say, I'm good at preaching. So I think that's my spiritual gift.
Okay, that's nice. We have a preacher.
Yes.
Okay, next.
I'm into preaching.
You are into preaching?
Yes.
Another preacher.
Okay. Wow.
Okay.
As for me, I like singing.
We have a singer. Okay.
Yeah, I'm into music and singing. Yes, I think that's my spiritual gift, because I spend most of the time when I come, that is at church, just music and singing.
Okay. And of course, me, I love teaching. That's my spiritual gift.
The man behind the camera?
As for me, I think singing. Though I haven't really nurtured it, like I said, I think that is the aspect that also is very important. You need to nurture your talent. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's one thing that I really need to work on.
Okay.
Yeah.
So those are our spiritual gifts. Some of them are yet to be sharpened because we are new believers. Some of our talents, our spiritual gifts that God has given us, we are yet to develop them. Someone can have more than two spiritual gifts, so we need to identify them. We do an audit that can help us identify what a spiritual gift is. What's the difference between having a talent and having a spiritual gift? What's the difference? What would you say the difference is? Yes.
Looking at what we have defined the spiritual gift as God given to the saints, but the talents, even outside there, people can have talents. It's more like something that God has just given to everyone. Just at birth, a person may have a talent, but when it comes to the spiritual gifts, the way we have learned is God imparts it to the members in the church.
Okay. So spiritual gifts are given by God. They are not given for the edification of only ourselves, but for the church. So they are there for evangelism. If you are just singing in the shower, and you say my spiritual gift is singing, hey, then spiritual gift. You're just preaching in the mirror.
Yeah.
No, your spiritual gift has to be exercised where? In the church. And bringing people where? To the fold. So your spiritual gift can be administration. But if that administration is done outside the church, then it's not a spiritual gift, it's a talent. You're just good at it. A spiritual gift is imbibed by the Holy Spirit. It is my prayer that you have learned one or two things about spiritual gifts, even as we continue meeting and learning more about spiritual gifts. We pray that at least for now we have had the foundation of what they are and what where they come from. May God bless us. Amen.
Amen.